See, from here, he said, I don't want to interfere, young fellow, but my guess is that you want to collect some money from Lyutkins. He never pays anybody a cent. He still owes me 50 cents on a poker game. I was a fool enough to play with him. He's not really bad, but it's hard to make him part with his money. If you try to collect from him in those fancy clothes, he will be suspicious and get away from you. If you won't, I will go into Fritz and ask for him, and you can keep out of sight behind me. What is Fritz here? Fritz is a person who possesses a shop. Understand? Now see the meaning of difficult words. Poker means it's a kind of game. Then locating means finding. Meaning of this paragraph. Now what happened? The delivery man started a conversation, means he started a talking with the clerk and inquired if the clerk had to take back his money from Lyutkins. Driver also told him that Lyutkins never paid anybody's debts back. Okay, he too, means the driver too, had to take back 50 cents from him, which he had won in the poker game, in a card game. The delivery man regretted being a fool who played with Lyutkins, though he was aware of his nature of non-payment of money. Understand? And later on, he suggested that he not to come in front of, means who should not come in front of Lyutkins? The clerk should not come in front of Lyutkins, because his fancy clothes could make Lyutkins doubt him and could give him a chance to run away. So he told him to stay behind him at Fritz's shop. Who is a Fritz? He is a person, or maybe one of the friend of this man, this driver. Actually, the driver is himself Lyutkins. Okay, who is giving a slip to the clerk. Understand? So now next paragraph. I loved him for this by myself. I might never have found Lyutkins with the hack driver's knowing help. I was sure of getting my ban. I summons on Lyutkins that the man had refused to be a witness. When his information would have quickly settled our case, the driver listened earnestly. At the end, he hit me on the shoulder and laughed. Well, we will give brother Lyutkins a little surprise. Understand? Now, hack driver. Hack driver means, I told you before, who drives a horse, cart or hack. Okay. Confidence means trust, belief. Next, earnestly means sincerely. So as the hack driver was working very hard for the clerk revealed him the truth behind his search for Lyutkins. Understand? He told the driver that Lyutkins was a witness in a very important case, but he was not helping them out by giving them the details. Understand? He was not helping out the company by giving the company details. That information of Lyutkins could help them in solving the case quickly. The driver heard all these things seriously and then hit on the clerk's shoulder and said that they would surprise Lyutkins by catching him and fulfilling the clerk's purpose. Okay. Now the next paragraph. Let's start, driver. Most folks around here call me Bill or Magnuson. My business is called William Magnuson Fancy Carting and Hacking. Okay. All right, Bill. Shall we proceed to Fritz? Yes. Lyutkins is just as likely to be there as anywhere. Plays a lot of poker. He is good at deceiving people. Bill seemed to admire Lyutkins' talent for dishonesty. I felt that if he had been a policeman, he would have caught Lyutkins respectfully and jailed him with regret. Okay, now see the meaning. Proceed means to begin, to start. Deceiving means cheating. Okay. Or giving slip. Admire means praise, appreciate. Then regret means to feel sorry or to be sorry. Now the meaning, So both they start their search for Liotkins. Okay. On their way, the hack driver introduced himself as Bill or Magnuson and said that his business was called William Magnuson Fancy Carting and Hacking. The clerk replied in a very friendly way that now he and Bill together should begin their search for the mission in order to get Liotkins. Bill also told him that Liotkins was fond of playing poker and also praised his ability to cheat others. Understand, he told this thing very happily. So this made clerk imagine about Bill, about that driver, that had he been a policeman, means had Bill, who is Bill here, hack driver. So he thought, he imagined that had he been a policeman, he would have caught Liotkins in a very respectful manner. Not only this, he would have felt bad to put Liotkins in a jail. Understand? Now, next paragraph. Bill led me into Fritz. Have you seen Oliver Liotkins around today? Friend of his looking for him. Friend of his looking for him, said Bill cheerily. Cheerily. So Fritz looked at me. See, now narrators is telling us Fritz looked at me, hiding behind Bill. Okay, he hesitated and then admitted, yes, he was in here a little while ago. Yes, he has gone over to Gustav's to get a shave. He told so. Who told this? Fritz. Fritz is a person, maybe one of his friend. Whose friend? Hack driver friend. Okay, so what he told? That Liotkins had gone to Gustav's shop or the barber to get a shave. Well, if he comes in, tell him I am looking for him. Okay, meaning? See the meaning? Cheerily means happily. Hesitated means be into mind stall. Admitted means confess. Now, Bill took the clerk to Fritz's shop. Okay. Bill, who is Bill? Hack driver. Hack driver or the delivery man took the clerk to Fritz's shop and inquired about Oliver Liotkins. He tried to appear natural by saying that his friend had come to meet him. Okay, it means the hack driver says, who is his friend? The clerk is his friend, and this friend has come to meet person, Liotkin. Okay. He did this to make Fritz tell the truth about Liotkins. At first, Fritz was confused, but then he said that Liotkins was there a few hours ago, but he left for Gustav's shop where he had gone for a shave. Understand? After getting the information, Bill asked Fritz to convey a message to Liotkins that he was looking for him. Means Liotkins is asking Fritz to convey a message. Okay, to Liotkins. Now, next paragraph. We drove to Gustav's barber shop. Again, Bill went in first, and I lingered at the door. He asked not only the Swede, but two customers if they had seen Liotkins. The Swede had not. He said angrily, I haven't seen him, and I don't care to. But if you find him, you can just collect that $1.35 he owes me. One of the customers thought he had seen Liotkins walking down Main Street this side of the hotel. Meaning, lingered means waited around. Then, Swede means a native or inhabitant of Sweden country or a person of Swedish descent. Understand? Now, they followed the shop. Means whose shop? Gustav's shop. And here also Bill went. Bill, who is Bill? The car driver. He went inside the shop first, and then the clerk waited for him outside. They had to face the anger of hairdresser because Liotkins had not paid his $35. Understand? But one of the customer told them in the shop that he had seen Liotkins in the main street near the hotel. Now, नेक्स्ट पैराग्राफ। सॉरी आई जस्ट फॉरगॉट टू टर्न द पेज, एक्चुअली आई एम रीडिंग फ्रॉम द ओरिजिनल बुक। नाउ सी फ्रॉम हियर, एज वी क्लाइम्ड, लास्ट पैराग्राफ, एज वी क्लाइम बैक इन टू द हैक, बिल कंक्लूडेड दैट सिंस ल्यूटकिंस हैड एग्जॉस्टेड हिज क्रेडिट एट गुस्ताफ्स, ही हैड प्रोबेबली गॉन टू ग्रेज फॉर अ शेव। एट ग्रेज बाबर शॉप वी मिस्ड ल्यूटकिंस बाय ओनली 5 मिनट्स, ही हैड जस्ट लेफ्ट प्रोबेबली फॉर द pool room. At the pool room, it appeared that he had just bought a pack of cigarettes and gone out. So we pursued him, just behind him, but never catching him for an hour till it was past 1 o'clock. I was hungry, but I had to enjoy Bill's rough country opinions about his neighbors that I scarcely cared whether I found Lutkins or not. Okay. Now, see the meaning of on this page, page number 49. Concluded means draw the judgment. The exhausted means used up, finished. Pool room, this is important word, a place to play pool, a betting shop. Understand? Next word is scarcely, with difficulty. There is one more word, pursued, means followed, chased. Then credit means remaining money. Now the meaning of this paragraph. So their attempts, their efforts to catch him, means catch Lutkins, were all in vain, useless. Almost an hour had passed and it was 1 o'clock in the afternoon and the clerk was hungry. But Bill's cheerfulness and his knowledge of the villagers was so delightful for him that he hardly bothered to find Lutkins. Understand? Now the next page. How about something to eat? I suggested. Let's go to a restaurant and I will buy you lunch. Well, I ought to go home to the wife. I don't care much for these restaurants. Only 4 of them and they are all bad. Tell you what we will do. We'll get the wife to pack up a lunch for us. She won't charge you more than $0.50 and it would cost you more for a greasy meal in a restaurant. And we will go up to Wade's Hill and enjoy the view while we eat. See the meaning on page number 50. Greasy means oily. Understand? And entirely means completely. Charge means took from, spent on behalf. Understand? Pastures means meadows, grasslands. Now see the meaning of the paragraph. Now the clerk asked Bill about having lunch as he was feeling hungry. He offered, means Bill offered, the hack driver offered to buy lunch for both of them from the restaurant. Actually, who offered to buy? The clerk offered to buy lunch for both of them from the restaurant. But Bill replied that there were only 4 restaurants and none of them cook good food. Okay. He said that he would get food from his wife. Bill also suggested the clerk to buy a food parcel from his wife as he had to pay only $0.50, which was far less than the price of the restaurant meal. Okay. Which was only and non-tasty. Which one is not tasty? Restaurant food. He also means Bill also suggested that they both go up the Wade's Hill. It's a name of hill, which was a nice place to view while they had their lunch. Okay. Now next paragraph. I know that Bill's helpfulness to the young fellow from the city was not entirely a matter of brotherly love. I was paying him for his time. In the end, I paid him for 6 hours, including the lunch hour, at what was then a very high price. But he was no more dishonest than I. I charged the whole thing to the firm. Understand? But it would have been worth paying him myself to have his presence. His cheerful country wisdom was very refreshing to a country boy like me who was sick of the city. As we sat on the hilltop, looking over the pastures and creek which slipped among the trees, he talked of New Mullion and painted a picture in words of all the people in it. He noticed everything, but no matter how much he might laugh at people. He also understood and forgave their foolishness. He described the minister's wife who sang the loudest in church when she was most in debt. He commented on the boys who came back from college in fancy clothes. He told about the lawyer whose wife could never succeed in getting him to put on both a collar and a tie on the same day. He made them all live. On that day, I came to know New Mullion better than I did the city and do to love it better. Okay, now see the meaning. Pastures means grassland. Creeks means a stream or minor. Tributary means a small river. Then commented means spoke about, remarked. Understand? Now the meaning of the paragraph. The narrator says that, means the clerk says that he knew that Bill was not helping him because of his helping nature, but because he was earning from him. Understand? This was the main reason, okay, for the help. He was getting paid for the 6 hours he spent with the clerk. Even the lunch hour during which they were sitting idle on a hilltop. Okay, he was comfortable with this because his law firm would bear all his expenses. Understand why he was comfortable or convenient? Because the company would bear all these expenses to be paid to him. Understand, whatever he paid to the hack driver, the same the company would pay to him. Understand? So he felt it to be dishonesty on his own part. Who felt this to be dishonesty? The clerk. Anyways, he was happy to get the company of such a cheerful person like Bill. Understand? While they were sitting on the hilltop, they saw the beautiful grasslands and the streams flowing through them. For the clerk, they were very beautiful, as he was also a villager and did not like the city life much. Bill told him everything about New Mullion. He explained everything and everyone in such a way that he felt like everything had happened in front of his own eyes. Bill told him about the minister's wife who would sing so loudly in the church whenever she was under debt. Okay, means whenever she was, or we can say that she has to pay off her credit or loans, she sang loudly in the church. So this means that she prayed to God for her problems. Understand? Then there were some college boys who would dress in such a fancy way, and the lawyer's wife who always failed in her attempt to make her husband wear both the collar and the tie on the same day. Then the clerk says that the Bill's knowledge of his village fellows was so good that it made him love the small town of New Mullion. He says that now he knew almost everything about this place where he was not much aware of the city he was living in. Okay, now the next paragraph. Bill didn't know about colleges and cities, but he had traveled around a lot of the country and had had a lot of jobs from his adventure. He had brought back a philosophy of simplicity and laughter. He strengthened me. Okay. Now, next paragraph. We left the peaceful, that peaceful scene of meadows and woods, and resume our search for Oliver Lutkins. He could not find him. We could not find him. At last, Bill cornered a friend of Lutkins and made him admit what he guessed. Oliver's gone out to his mother's farm, 3 miles north. We drove out there laying plans. See the meaning? Adventures means exploit or event. Philosophy means ideology, beliefs. Resume means restart. Meadows means field pastures. Okay, then cornered means forced into a place or a situation or a position. Now the meaning of the paragraph. Bill knew nothing about colleges and cities life. Okay, maybe because he never got the chance to visit these places. But he knew everything about the village and small towns as he had done different types of job at these places. He got his ideology of simplicity and cheerful nature as a gift by exploiting these places. He tried to build faith in the narrator that they would surely catch Liutkins. Understand? So clever he was. Both of them left the beautiful fields and restarted their search mission. Understand? And at last, Bill forced one of Liutkin's friends to admit that Liutkin had run away to his mother's house, which was 3 miles away from New Million. So both of them, means the hack driver and the clerk, prepared to drive to Liutkin's mother in order to find Liutkin's, Oliver Liutkin's. Understand? Now the next page. I know Oliver's mother. She's a terror. Bill sighed. I took a trunk out there for her once and she almost took my skin off because I didn't treat it like a box of eggs. She is about 9 feet tall and 4 feet thick and quick as a cat. And she sure can talk. I will bet Oliver heard that somebody's chasing him and he has gone on there to hide behind his mother's skirts. Well, we will try her. But you would better let me do it, boy. You may be great at literature and law, but you haven't had real training in swearing. Understand? Meaning, terror means great fear. Okay. Chasing means following. Swearing means taking an oath. Okay. Enormous means great. Now the meaning of the paragraph. Then he told that Liutkins must have come to know that they were searching for him. Who were searching for him? Hack driver and the clerk. Okay. He must have come to know about this. That's why he had run to his mother's place in order to hide himself behind her. Okay. Or in support of her. He also suggested that the narrator should let him deal with the mother as he doubted that the clerk would not be able to extract the truth from the lady's mouth. So he should not speak there before his mother. Understand? Now, the next paragraph, we drove. Into a proof farmyard, we were faced by an enormous and cheerful old woman. My guide bravely went up to her and said, "Remember me. I am Bill Mengusen, the carter and hackman. I want to find your son, Oliver." "I don't know anything about Oliver and I don't want to," she shouted. Okay. Now the meaning of difficult words. See, enormous means large. Huge. Now, when they reached the farmland, who reached? Both of them, means the car driver and the clerk. They found a heavily built, cheerful old lady. Bill went up to her with guts and introduced himself by saying that he was Bill Mengusen and also told her that he was Bill Mengusen and he was searching for her son Oliver. Understand? So the lady replied by shouting, that she knew nothing about Oliver Lutkins. Okay, now next paragraph. Now look here. We have had just about enough nonsense. This young man represents the court in the city, and we have a legal right to search all properties for this Oliver Lutkins. Bill made me sound very important, and the woman was impressed. She retired into the kitchen and we followed. She seized an iron from the old-fashioned stove and marched on us shouting, "You search all you want to, if you don't mind getting burnt first," she shouted and laughed at our frightened retreat. See the meaning of difficult words. Seized means caught, and frightened, fearful. Retreat means withdrawal. Okay. And retired means went inside. Now, Bill got a bit strict with the lady and said that they had been through tough and confusing things, and then introduced her to the clerk by saying that he was a person, means the clerk was a person appointed by the city court, and he also said that they had got the legal right to search her house to find Oliver Lutkins. Understand? The clerk was very happy as he was getting due importance from Bill, and even the lady seemed impressed by Bill. She went into the kitchen and both of them followed her. They got shocked there. She took out a hot iron from the stove and threatened them to burn. She laughed when they stepped back due to fear. Understand? Let's get out of here. Now, next paragraph. She will murder us, Bill whispered. Outside, he said, "Did you see her smile? She was laughing at us." I agreed that it was pretty disrespectful treatment. We did, however, search the house. Since it was only one story high, Bill went round it, peering it at all the windows. We examined the barn and stable. We were reasonably certain that Lutkins was not there. It was nearly time for me to catch the afternoon train, and Bill drove me to the station. See the meaning of words. Whispered means murmured, means spoke slowly. Disrespectful means rude, impolite behavior. Examine means to look or consider a person or a place. Barn means house, shelter. Stable means a place where we keep the horses, or the horses are tied up. Now the reaction of the lady was so horrible that Bill murmured to the clerk to leave the place quickly. He agreed that the behavior of the women was very rude, yet they managed to search the whole house, including the outhouse and the stable and so on. As it was a single-storied building, they managed to search the whole of the house and could not find Lutkins there anywhere. As the clerk was getting late for his train, therefore Bill took him to the station finally. Okay. Now, on the way to the city, I worried very little over my failure to find Lutkins. I was too busy thinking about Bill Mengusen. Really, I considered returning to New Mullion to practice law. If I had found Bill so deep and richly human, might I not grow to love Fritz and Gustav and 100 other slow-spoken, simple, wise neighbors? I pictured an honest and happy life beyond the strict limits of universities and law firms. I was excited. I had found a treasure. I had discovered a new way of life. Now the meaning. While the narrator was heading back, okay, when he was moving back towards the city, he did not regret his failure in delivering summons to Lutkins. Okay, rather he was very happy. He was still thinking about Bill Mengusen and felt like going back to New Mullion and start his practice there. He felt a certain kind of attachment with all the people of the village, such as Fritz and then Gustav, whom he considered humble speakers and wise neighbors. And he imagined a life which was honest, simple and joyous, means happy, which was not experienced by him in the boundaries of his university of law firm. He was so happy that he felt as if he had got some kind of treasure and had found a new way of life. Now the next paragraph. But if I did not think much about Lyutkins, the office did. I found them all upset. Next morning, the case was coming up in the court and they had to have Lyutkins. I was shameful, useless fool. That. Morning, my promising legal career almost came to an end before it had begun. Shameful means disgraceful. Promising means hopeful. Now meaning, though the narrator was not so worried about finding Lyutkins, but his firm was. Okay, his firm was eager to find out Lyutkins. The people there got very upset in the company on hearing that he was not able to serve the summons. Means the clerk was not able to serve the summons by from the company. Understand? He was insulted by being called shameful and useless. He felt that it was his last day in the office as his career was about to over. The chief almost murdered me. See the next paragraph. He hinted that I might do well at digging ditches. I was ordered back to New Mullion, and with me went a man who had worked with Lyutkins. I was rather sorry because it would prevent my loafing all over again with Bill. Hinted means suggest. Digging means to till the land. Okay. Ditches means a drain or a trench. Loafing means spend time in the idle way. Meaning, now the narrator's chief was very angry with him. He treated him so badly that the clerk felt as if he would murder him. Not only this, he also suggested him, means the clerk, that he was better for the job of tilling the land or tilling a drain or something else. He was again sent to New Mullion with a man who had worked with Lyutkins. Okay, the clerk was feeling bad not for what happened, but because he would miss the chance to be with Bill. Now, next paragraph. When the train arrived at New Mullion, Bill was on the station platform near his cart. Strangely enough, that old tigress, Lyutkin's mother, was there taking and laughing with Bill, not quarreling at all. From the train steps, I pointed Bill out to my companion and said, "There's a fine fellow, a real man. I've spent the day with him." Okay. He helped you hunt for Oliver Lyutkins? Yes, he helped me a lot. He must have. He is Lyutkins himself. Okay, meaning companion means friend, partner or associate. Hunt means search for. Now see the meaning of the paragraph. That is very shocking. When both the narrator and his new partner, who worked with Lyutkins, reached New Mullion station, they saw Bill on the platform. But to this narrator's surprise, means to this, but to his surprise, whose surprise? Narrator's, means the clerk's surprise. Bill was talking and laughing with Lyutkin's mother, whom the narrator compared to a tigress for her rude behavior. He then told his partner that it was Bill, a nice man who helped him search for Lyutkins. But the clerk was surprised by the answer given by that companion. That man who helped him find Lyutkins was none other than Lyutkins himself. Understand? Means Bill was Lyutkin himself. Now, so next, what really hurt me was that when I served the summons, Lyutkins and his mother laughed at me as though I were a bright boy of 7. With loving kindness, they begged me to go with them to a neighbor's house for a cup of tea. I told them about you and they are anxious to look at you, said Lutkins joyfully. They are about the only folks in the town they missed seeing you yesterday. See the meaning, begged means to request. Anxious means concerned, worried. Folks means people here. Now, the thing that pissed the clerk or the narrator a lot was that both the mother and son were laughing at him when he served Lutkins with the summons. Understand? Not only this, they requested him, means mother and the son, or we can say Lutkins and his mother requested the clerk to join them for a coffee at a neighbor's house because they were the only people left in the village who had not seen him yesterday when he was searching for Lutkins, though Lutkins was riding with him in the hack. Understand? So, the hack driver is the story of a very cunning manipulator, Bill Oliver Lutkins. Okay. It also shows that appearances are often deceptive. So, once the clerk, a junior clerk in a law firm, had to go to New Mullion to serve a summons to Oliver Lutkins. There he met Bill. And who is Bill here? Actually, Bill himself is Oliver Lutkins, the hack driver. Okay, when the narrator asked about Oliver Lutkins, Bill took him to Fritz, who replied, means Fritz is one of the friend of Lutkins. And Fritz replied that Oliver had been there a little while ago. Bill, who was Oliver Lutkins himself, made a plan to befool the narrator in a very friendly but subtle way. Bill manipulated the tour, taking the lawyer around the village. He arranged meetings with Fritz, Gustav shop owner, a barber, etc. Then Bill took him to Oliver Lutkins' mother, who was a terrible huge woman who threatened to beat them, and finally he returned disappointed. Okay, who returned disappointed? The clerk. He couldn't trace Oliver Lutkins at all. His boss, means the clerk's boss, rebuked him badly and asked him to go back to New Mullion with a person who knew Lutkins. And when they reached there, he found Bill and Lutkins' mother together. The man, means who worked with Lutkins once, recognized Lutkins, and he told Bill he is no one but Lutkins himself. Understand? So that's all about the chapter, The Hack Driver. Thank you so much.